Hello friend, my name is Sunil Kumar. In this video, we will learn how to implement the distributed locking into the MuleFlow. So we will name it as distributed locking. Right. So we will use the Java component init to implement the distributed locking. Let's first put the HTTP into our canvas. Make it as a default configuration to get the request, and we will use the Java transformer to delegate the request to our server. So first of all, we will create a new package, say lock. Invoke lock path and a new class Java class apply locking, and it should, to get the Mule context object, it should extend abstract message transform. So it should be struct message transform. Okay. So it should be struct message transform, and it implemented the unimplemented. So now we have access to our Mule context object. So let's make it Mule context dot get log factory dot create log, and I will say is that one of three, these four I have log I have created. So let's take this log object to log into the system, and this log object should be of Java dot util dot concurrent logs. Okay, so I will say is that obj, it should be log obj. So I am containing the log over here, and after that one, if I do anything in the try, say this out, this will happen synchronously. So I will say inside locking clock, and anything I can put it. So just for testing, this time I am putting thread.sleep method, and I am sleeping it for 10 seconds, right? So I have to use the catch, where I have to catch the exception. So right now I will use the catch, the simple exception. And then I will inside the finally log, what I will do, I will clear my log. So log obj dot unlock method I will call. So now it will unlock it, right? So let's configure this, and the transforming object class, the name of our class is apply locking. So it will hit this request, and we will use the two loggers just to test the system how it will behave. So we will set the message as before and this message as after. So at any point of the time, only one request should be there inside my locking system. So if it got two requests, it will process one at a time. So let's see with one example how it will get processed into the system. So let the application get deployed. So the application is deployed. So let's clear the logs, and I hit one request with this one and the second request with this. Okay, so there is no endpoint. So the filter is, we have used the locking as a path. So let's copy it, paste it as locking. Let's copy it, paste it as locking. So we will hit, let's go to the logs, clear out the logs, and hit two requests at a time. So I hit one request, and at the same time I hit two requests. Now the system got two requests. One, it is before and inside the locking block. The second is waiting, and as soon as the first request clear the locks, now it hit the second request. So just to, if let me increase this time and restart the server, so it will give us the better clarity how the system will behave. So at a time, only one request will get processed inside the locking block. So we are, you know, applying the locking into the message processor. Wherever we want to perform any critical stuff, that we can perform in this try block, right? And finally it will release the logs. So let's clear the logs and hit the request two times, one and second. Go to the logs, we can see one is inside the locking block. It means one is inside the try block, and second is waiting to go inside the try block, because it is, this logger is get printed before. So as soon as my, after logger will get printed for the first request, the second request, so the first request after will get printed, now second request is inside the try block, and then 20 seconds over, this request will get processed. So this way we can implement the distributed locking into the Mule through Java using the Mule context.getLogFactory.createLog method. Thanks for watching. Thank you.